Let us now discuss the common data types in C. Before we proceed to talk about the common data types in C, let me tell you a word which is very frequently thrown around. Variables, constants, functions, and a few other things are known as objects. So when I say an object, I could be talking about a variable or a constant. By the term variable, I mean a memory location whose values can change. Constant also is a memory location, except that it does not change. Example of a constant is pi 3.142. Example of a variable could be a people's address, which can keep changing. Now, why is the type of data very important in programming? The type of data determines what values can be stored in that particular object or that particular variable. For example, if the data type is characters, I can only store addresses there. In a character type of data, I cannot store somebody's age or anything. It's meaningless. So that's why the type of data really determines the values that can be contained. Now, the type of data also determine what all operations are meaningful and sensible on that particular data type. For example, I can add everybody's height or age and find the average. It doesn't make sense for me to add everybody's addresses or everybody's PIN code and try to find something. It is actually a meaningless operation. So data type is important for the values it can hold and the operations that can be performed. Now let's talk about the most frequently used data in C. All right. C provides you four types of built-in data and small variations around this built-in data, which we will take a look at it later on. The first type of data is characters, represented by single characters like A, B, C and all, and it is identified or declared using the keyword char in C. C-H-A-R is pronounced as char. Next is integer type of data, identified or declared by the keyword int. It can be positive, negative, zero, but it cannot contain a decimal point. Floating point numbers are real numbers, okay, like pi, it could be somebody's salary, okay, it could be somebody's height. These are all examples of floating point numbers. Double is also a type of floating point number, except that it has twice the precision or twice the accuracy of float. I'll just clarify what I mean. According to IEEE standard, floating point number is represented using 32 bits, whereas double is represented using 64 bits. So here if you have accuracy of 7 bits after the decimal point, here you will have approximately 15 bits. So that's what it's the name double. So let's try to take a look at one data type at a time. So the first data type I'm going to take a look at is character or char. An example of character type of data is this. These are all examples of character type of data. Character types of data always occupy 1 byte, that is 8 bits of memory in your main memory. So they are always enclosed in single quotes. If you enclose in double quotes, it's a totally different thing called as strings. So be careful that character is going to be enclosed only in single quotes. The next type of data I'm going to talk about is going to be integers. Integers examples are 0, 2, minus 3, 900, minus 3400, so on. Now with integers, the interesting part is the size of the integers is machine dependent. The size is determined by the compiler operating on that particular hardware. But most generally, it's either going to be 2 bytes or it's going to be 4 bytes. So that is what should be enough to at this stage to know about integers. Now, the next data type is the single precision floating point number. Okay, so let's take a look at the next data type, which happens to be the single precision floating point number. So the single precision floating point number is identified in C by the keyword or declared with the keyword called as float. Everything, mind you, is in lower case. These are all examples of floating type of variables. Again, the size is dependent on a machine. Wherever possible, prefer to use integers over float or double. The reason being, arithmetic operations generally on integers are going to be much faster than on double or float. The reason is float or double are stored in different combinations. Like there's a sign bit, there is a mantissa, and there's an exponent and things like that. So its processing is going to be much slower. So please, preferably given a choice, select integer data type. But not every time just you have to select integer, you select. If somebody's salary is a real number, put it as a floating point number. Now, as I had told you briefly earlier, double precision floating point number has twice the precision of float. That means according to IEEE standard, this is 32 bits, this is 64 bits. This is accuracy of 7 decimal digits, this is accuracy of 15 decimal digits. Again, the size is dependent on the hardware of the machine, which the compiler makes a call as to what size I should give it for double on that particular machine. This is generally used in scientific and engineering calculation where the highest degree of accuracy is required. The capacity of this is much, much higher than float. Okay. Now, last but not the least, all right, I'm going to talk about a data type called as string. A string is nothing but it's a collection of zero or more characters enclosed in double quotes. So this is an example of a string. Goodbye, backslash n. After goodbye is printed, the cursor will go to the next line. This is also a string, except that this is an empty string. That means the string has no length. So string is simply a collection of zero or more characters. This chap is known as the null string. So I just gave you a brief idea about what are the different types of data used in C. We will be going into each of the data types in much detail in the coming sessions. Be sure you are very comfortable understanding all the concepts pertaining to data, because this is something students do not pay enough attention, and especially when you are doing coding, it can give you a lot of problems if you are not clear with the concept of data or what are their width, what all, what they can do, what they cannot do, and things like that.